Hey everyone, Brandon from Brandon's Baseball Cards here. Tonight's video is I'm going to show some mail, some stuff that came in today, but I'm going to start with something that happened the past few days that I think it's worth those of you that collect packs or those of you that purchase sports memorabilia and things on eBay. It's something to be aware of. I recently purchased a 1983 Topps baseball rack pack. Really, really cool pack. It had Nolan Ryan in one on the top in one cell, a Nolan Ryan Super Veterans insert card on top in the second cell, and a Tim Raines All-Star card on top in the third cell. So we're talking three Hall of Famers showing, and two of them are being the same player, two being Nolan Ryan. So very, very cool, and I was ecstatic when I saw this. The price seemed very fair. I made it, it was a buy it now or best offer. I made it an offer to the dealer, he accepted. And when I purchased the item, I had him ship the rack pack to Baseball Card Exchange. I explained I'm a pack collector and I would like this authenticated and top loaded for my collection, and the dealer very kindly obliged. However, yesterday afternoon, I got an email from Steve Hart, the owner of Baseball Card Exchange. And in this email, in a very, very detailed email, five, six paragraphs, long paragraphs, he explained why he was unable to authenticate this 1983 Topps baseball rack pack. And it was a very, very insightful email. I learned a lot about the types of things they look for when they're authenticating this stuff. So, for example, he examines the collation of the cards in the packs to make sure that, you know, if a pack's been tampered with, the collation will be different than the standard collation scheme that was put out by Topps. And he pointed out to me not only that in one of the cells, the collation scheme was something he had never seen before for a 1983 Topps baseball pack. Not only that, but there was one little section in this, again, in the middle cell, only in one cell of the pack, where it looks, but maybe, he couldn't say for sure, maybe someone had recrimped the plastic very sneakily if they did. And so he could not say for certain that this rack pack had not been altered. And he, you know, basically, you know, apologized, you know, for, you know, the bad news. And he, you know, but he basically said, you know, I can only authenticate this if I am certain it is authentic. And if there's any doubt, I can't do it. And I respect that so much because it is a true service to the hobby. But this is something to be aware of if you are a pack collector. Be aware on eBay, if it seems too good to be true, especially if my mistake was, I bought, you know, a pack with three Hall of Famers showing on top. That's not impossible to happen, but I should have been more skeptical. But the best decision that I did make in this transaction was I had the dealer send the pack directly to Baseball Card Exchange. And when Steve sent me this long message explaining why he couldn't authenticate the pack, I sent the dealer a refund request and I attached the email to the refund request, and the dealer instantly granted me the refund. Within 2 minutes, the refund was granted. So I don't know what that means. I don't know if it means the dealer knew the pack wasn't legit. I don't know if it means the dealer was just embarrassed and just wanted to get the transaction over with. Whatever it was, I received a very quick refund, which I'm thankful for. I didn't want to have to go through a headache. You know, this pack was $47 after shipping. I didn't want to go through a headache over, you know, a transaction that was not that much money, relatively speaking. But Steve Hart is the reason I'm able to get my money back because of his attention to detail. And to top it all off, in addition to this very, very detailed email explaining, he also didn't charge me for the authentication. Normally, the authentication fee applies whether the item is deemed to be good or not. And he said, don't worry about paying the authentication fee for this. And he said it was because he learned a lot, too, about some of the ways that maybe they're trying to, some are attempting to forge rack packs. And I learned just a lot in this email. I learned that it's actually rack packs are being faked more than ever before. He basically said that you really need to be skeptical and you need to be careful when you're buying rack packs on eBay. And if the price is too good to be true, and if the item is, like this item's a great example, if it's too awesome, you know, it's just too cool, you know, two Nolan Ryan cards showing and then a Tim Raines on top, you should be a skeptical buyer. It doesn't mean it's fake, right? And in the dealer's defense, this could be a legitimate pack. Steve just couldn't definitively say that it was. And so it's good to have this service in the hobby. It really, really, it's invaluable to collectors such as myself, and it keeps the hobby honest. I'm sending the rack pack back to the dealer. I really hope they don't put it back on eBay. But if you see an 83, if you're getting into rack packs or if you collect this type of stuff and you see an 83 Topps rack pack with two Nolan Ryan cards on top and a Tim Raines showing, don't buy it. Because it's not going to be able to be authenticated. And that's authentication is everything with unopened material. Okay, so with that, I want to show you a few things that I got in the mail. Something kind of different today. I got, I'm a bidder with Kevin Savage cards. I used to bid with them a lot when I was younger. And I recently decided to give their auctions another shot. And I bought this 1955 Bowman football card of Norm Van Brocklin, who is a Hall of Famer. And this is a great, great example of buying the card, not the grade. This is PSA graded good too. If anyone could look at the front of this and would ever think that this would be graded a good two, you'd be crazy, right? It's a beautiful card, nice bright colors, clean borders. The problem is, and I'm not gonna show the back because I don't think it will. You can even see them. There are spider creases all along the back. But the front's gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. Hall of Famer, beautiful set. This is probably my favorite football set. I love 55 Bowman football. I don't buy a lot of football stuff, but when I do, it's usually 55 Bowman, just because they're so pretty. So that came in the mail today, I was very happy with that. And I got a couple rack packs, shocker, from Baseball Card Exchange. The first is a 1985 Topps rack with a none other than Cal Ripken Jr. on top, which I thought was really, really cool. Very fair price on eBay. The dealer once again sent it directly to Baseball Card Exchange, and it's just an absolutely beautiful, beautiful pack. And again, this is as recent or as modern as I would get if you are a pack collector. Don't go beyond 1985. I mean, you could technically invest and make some money, you know. If you play the long game, I suppose, if you want to invest in 87 Donruss or something, go ahead. I mean, I'm not going to be doing that. 85 and earlier, that's it for me. That's where the value is. I was happy to get that pack. And then also, I got this directly from Baseball Card Exchange. This is a 1983 Donruss rack pack. And you do not see very many of these. These are not common. I think there's one on eBay right now, and it's ridiculously expensive. These are not common. And I saw one day randomly on the Baseball Card Exchange website, they had three of them. And so I just snatched one. I sent Steve an email and said, can I get one of these and can you wrap it for me? $15. Of course, it costs, you know, $8 to get it wrapped, but $15 before I got it wrapped. And I've never sent, again, I've seen one on eBay. One. So there are wax racks of this year that are relatively common, but I have not seen just a regular rack pack in quite a while. So those are my pickups. I will have some more mail coming hopefully in the next week or two. My videos may be a little bit sporadic now because my wife and I have our second child. We have a healthy little baby boy that was born on February 21st. And so we're, you know, tired parents to a newborn. So my videos may be a little sporadic, but I hope you've enjoyed this one. I hope you're all doing well, and keep collecting vintage baseball.